mental health. The moment I utter the words, people run away from me. Because somewhere or the other, people think that when we talk about mental health, we are talking about mental illness. But mental health is the same as physical health. Physical health, I may be perfectly healthy, I may be a little down and out, or I may be suffering from a major illness. There's a continuum. The same thing applies for the mental health. There are people who are very happy and who are very contented and leading a good life. There are people who have had ups and downs and are feeling little down. There are people who are under severe depression. And there's a small percentage of people who are suffering from major mental illness. But there's a lot that we can do other than maybe a person suffering from a major mental illness, psychosis as we call it, which definitely requires the attention and the therapy by a professional, mental health professional. The 90% of the population, each one of us can do something to help improve mental health. Now, what is mental health? Let me give you a very, very oversimplistic example. Mental health, according to me, is peace within yourself and harmony with others. Peace within yourself. Yes, there are times when I'm a little disturbed, I'm confused, I'm depressed, but I bounce back. If I can say truthfully that most of the time, I am at peace within myself, I know how to handle, I can, you know, cope with stress and things like that. Second part, harmony with others. And who others? The important people, my inner circle. Can I maintain healthy long-term relationships with the people who are important to me? Again, you'll have small fights, you'll have disagreements, but every time do we bounce back and again we feel connected. So if a person can maintain that level where the person is at peace within himself and in harmony with others, he's got good mental health. Now, once in a while, somebody's mental health goes down. He goes into a depression because some setback has happened. Stresses go so high that he starts getting short-tempered and angry and all that. People don't even realize that these are very minor but very curable disorders. Before a person comes to the point where he is labeled as a short-tempered and a horrifying person, you can nip it in the bud. We all need to become conscious of the fact that the preservative and preventive aspects of mental health is within our domain. We don't need psychiatrists and psychologists for that. You maintain good harmonious relationships. Lift up a person who seems to be down and out. Be sensitive to the needs of each other. And we can build a small community or society around us where even if a person's mental health takes a dip, he comes back again. So on this occasion of World Mental Health Day, let us resolve that we will do our little bit, each one of us, to ensure that the mental health of ourselves, our loved ones, and people around us, whoever we meet, is maintained at a good level so that we live in a better world than what we are living right now.